In this class, we are going to discuss about code converters. As the name indicates, these code converters are used to convert one type of code to another type of code. For example, we are having so many codes like binary code, BCD code and gray code like that. So, to take conversion from one code to another code, we are making use of this code converters. So, now as an example of this code converter design, we are using binary to BCD converter. So, as we know that, for example, 2 bit numbers like in decimal 2 bit means 10 onwards, up to 9 binary and BCD are same, but 10 onwards. So, here in binary we are representing 10 just like 1010, but in BCD we are representing like 2 bits separately. That means, see here. For example, in binary, if you want to represent any 10, so this you are representing like 1010. But in case of BCD, same thing, if you want to represent same 10 in BCD, you need to consider code for 1 separately and 0 separately, that means for 10. So, 1 means at least 1 you need to consider to represent 0. So, 4 zeros I am taking, and to represent this one, 3 zeros 1. So, like this you need to represent in case of BCD. So, here by combining these two codes separately for 1 and 0, which we take in separately for 1 and 0, it will becomes the BCD of 10. So, for example, anyone asked you what is the BCD for 10, then definitely you can represent 0001 4 zeros, or at least you need this one and these 4 zeros to represent 10 in BCD code. So, see here, our intention is to create a converter which will convert some binary to BCD code. So, here our input of that particular converter is always binary, as that is a binary to BCD converter, input is binary and output is BCD. So, you know that to represent any 2 bit decimal numbers, so for example 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 like that, so BCD require at least 5 digits. See, you can observe here, so I take in binary of 4 bits. That means 0 to 15, why I take in 4 bit binary means, so if I take in 3 bit binary, there is no change of BCD and binary, no need of converter itself. So, the main conversion starts from 2 bit decimal onwards, that means 10 onwards. So, here that's why, so for to represent 10, definitely this binary require 4 bits, that's why I take in 4 bit binary here. So, as I represented 4 bit binary here, so up to you can see, so this is 0 to 9, so 1001 means 9, 0 to 9, so here also you are getting same thing, so 0 to 9, all these BCD and binary are same. I am just putting 0, I am just going to put 0 in place of this 5th bit up to 9. From 9 onwards, definitely I need to take 1 in place of this MSB bit for BCD conversion. Why? Because for example, if you want to represent 10, you can represent in 2 powers in binary like 1010. 8421 as difference. So, here for example, if you want to represent 11, 1011 you need to consider, but to represent same 11 in case of this BCD, so definitely 1 separately and 1 separately you need to consider. So, by considering like that, at least 1 bit you need to consider in MSB side, that means this one, and 0001 represent this LSB one. So, in similar way, I am representing 12 with 1, 2 and 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5. Like this, I am going to represent my resultant BCD for this binary. Now, my aim is to design to get, or my aim is to get each port. And for example, if you are having any converter that is having 4 bits as input, it is giving some BCD code as output with 5 bits. up to 9, up to 9 the fifth bit is equal to 0 at output, but 10 and onwards, so your fifth bit, that means MSB bit at the output of that particular binary to BCD converter shows you 1. So we need to design this functionality. So we take in the truth table for our required functionality. So we just converted binary to BCD. So now our aim is to take each column. So here I am taking each column. So where you are having E as 1 means from 10 onwards, that means E means MSB bit. So from 10 onwards, when you got double digit number in decimal, from there onwards your MSB bit is equal to 1. So you can see here E is equal to having min terms 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. You can write like this. So E is equal to M of summation of M of 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. You can write like this. So I'm going to take the K map for each column like E, F, G, H, I to get the expression for each column. Then I am taking the logic circuit finally. Now how many variable K map we need to consider means definitely this BCD code is from this binary. So the input of the code converter is of binary with 4 bits. So 4 digit K map we need to consider, 4 variable K map we need to consider. You can see here I take in 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I skipped one row and 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So these are the cell values, nothing but cell values. You can write when you are drawing your K maps for simple easy access of that K map. I just take in that values. You can observe. For example, here is 4, 0, 1, 0, 0, nothing but 4. So like that it will come, or if you want any pick mark like that. So you just want any mark like that, you want to mark these values in your mind. You just put 0, 1, 2, 3, skip one column and you just write 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7 and you just skip this total row and you just come to this down row 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. You need to skip at last. Okay. So then now I am placing values in this K maps to get the expression for each column. Now, so I am taking K map for E. E is equal to 1 from 10 to 15. So here at 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15 you are having E as 1. Now this is the time for grouping. So how we can group these two means, so here I am grouping this quarter, so I am grouping this quarter and here also I am grouping this quarter. So two quarters I group like this. So now I am taking the prime implicant values, the expression from this to E. So here from this E is equal to I am taking this quarter value. So this value, this side it's covering two cells. In these two cells, so one is common, means it's equal to A, it represents A. Into top side it is covering two cells, the two cell values are 11 and 10. In that one is common, that one represents C. So totally this side A, top side C means AC. So this is equal to AC plus, so this horizontal prime implicant I am taking, another quarter I am taking. So this side it's covering only single cell, you can take as it is. Top side it is covering four cells, there is no combination, there is no common value in that four cells. So definitely this will be its final value of this prime implicant. So this 11 represents AB, AC plus AB will be the equation for E from this truth table. So now in the same way I am going to draw the K map for F. So you can see where you are having 1s in F. So only at two places you can find F here. So here you are having 1 at 8 and 1 at 9. Only two places you are having 1 in the place of F. So those two places are 8 and 9. So here I am taking those two values. So you can clearly observe there is no other places that is having 1 in the F column. So these two I am grouping as it is. So this value itself represents the equation for F. F is equivalent to, so this side it's covering single cell. So top side is covering two cells. First of all, this single cell value you can take as it is, that means A B bar. In B place you are having 0, means that represents B bar, A B bar. So next you are having top side, it's covering two cells. Top side it's covering two cells means these two cells values in common value with 0, the starting 0 is common, so that represents C bar. So A B bar C bar will be the value of F. F is equal to A B bar C bar. Now in the same way we are going to draw the K map for G. So now see here where G is equivalent to 1. So here you can found 4 plus 2, 6 cases where G is equal to 1. So here 4, 5, 6, 7 places. So 4, 5, 6, 7 places, and then another 2 is at 14, 15 places. So that means you can observe at last at 14, 15 cases. So you are having 1s. Now again I am grouping this quarter and this quarter. I am grouping this quarter. So now here this prime implicant value, so G is equal to, I am writing this prime implicant, this is covering two cells sidewise, one is common, that one represent B. So top wise it's covering another two cells, the combination is again one, first one that represents C. So BC plus, so here this horizontal prime implicant quarter, so this one sidewise covering single cell, top wise four cells, no combination, only side value we will take. So 0 1 means A bar B. So A bar B will be the, so BC plus A bar B will be the G value. So finally we are taking K map for H and I. So here where you are having H is equivalent to 1 means again at 6 places you are observing H as 1. That means here you are having at 2, 3 place and at 6, 7 place. So 2, 3 place. So and 6, 7 place, and another places you can observe in 12, 13 places. So 12, 13 means here you can observe 1. So see clearly. So here at 2, 3 place you are having 1, and here at 6, 7 place you are having 1 at H, and finally 12, 13 places you are having 1. So now it's the time for grouping. Is there any quarter possible means, yes, this quarter is possible here and this double is possible here. So now I am taking the value for H here. So H is equal to, I am taking the quarter value sidewise, combination is 0, represents A bar. Top wise the combination is equal to 1. You can observe first one is common, that first one represents C. So A bar C plus, I am taking this double value sidewise represents, so AB top wise it's having combination, that combination is 0, represents C bar, ABC bar, A bar C plus ABC bar will be the equivalent expression for H. So similarly, so here I am taking the K map for I. So K map for I means where you are having ones means, so at 1 and at 3, so at 1, at 3, and at 5, at 7, so at 5, at 7, and here after 7 you are having at 9, every alternate place you are having 1 I think. So at 9 and at 11, so 9, so here is 9 and 11, so here you can observe 11, after that 13 and 15. So all these places you are having ones. So now you can group, so a octet, so this value sidewise H having no combination because it covered all the cells. When it covers covers all the cells, there won't be any combination. Top wise is covering only two cells, so there may be a combination. That combination is second one. Second one represents D. I is equal to D directly. So now this is the time to get the logic diagram equivalent for this conversion. So now our input is binary code. Now your BCD digits you need to convert. That means your BCD digits that you need to get at the output. To get E, what is the expression means? AC plus AB. So here I am taking A and C. So multiplication AC and AB means, so here I am taking another A and B means, so from here. So I taken two AND gates and I am taking an OR gate. It will provide you E. So it will definitely provide you E. So in the same way, so here to get expression for F, just take A, B bar, C bar. So here I am taking A and B bar means from complement line which I represented with red mark. So A, B bar, C bar. C bar means again with this. So you just take an AND gate, you are going to get your F value, EF. So next, at G, BC plus A bar B. So BC means B and C. So just put consider an AND gate. So BC plus A bar B. A bar B means from complement line of A bar. So B. So these two are added to provide your G value. So now finally H value. So H equal to A bar C. So here complement line A bar and this is C, A bar C and A, B and C bar. C bar means here. So by adding these two, you are going to get your value for H, that means second digit of your BCD. Finally, I is equal to D. So if you take in D line as it is, this is nothing but I. So for example, your ABCD is equivalent to 1100. That means 12 you given. What you need to get at output means, so you can observe here, if you given 1100, you need to get 10010 at output. Let me check here. So if you are having 1100 here, definitely the because of NOT gates, you are getting outputs like 0011 at complement places. So see here, this NOT and this AND gate is connected here with 0, so output is 0. Any one input of AND gate is 0 means it's providing 0. See here, this AND gate is connected 0 here, and finally here this AND gate is providing 1. So here 1 means this is providing 1 into 1. So any one of the input is 1 for OR gate, output is 1 here. And another thing I am taking here, so here output is 1 at E place, and same thing, see here, to get F, so 1 into, so 0 into, so it became 0. By seeing itself 0 at any one place of AND gate, it is getting 0 only. And here we are having 2 AND gates, so here we are having 0 in this line, see this C line. So for this AND gate, this is 0 means it's giving 0, and here so it's taking A bar, that means here you are having 0, so this also going to 0. So totally by adding 2 zeros, again also you are getting 0. And now see this AND gate, so again it's taking 0 from this complement line, so providing 0 by multiplying with that 0. So here you can observe, so this line, so this AND gate is providing 1, I think. So here you are having 1, here also you are having 1, and in this line also you can observe 1. By multiplying 3 ones, it's giving 1. 0 plus 1, it will provide 1 here. So now finally you are having your I line, that means 0. So see the output of this BCD. So your BCD output is 10010. So 10010. So definitely this is the output 1 and 2. That is the BCD, your BCD output you need to get for 12, 1100. Like this way we can convert from any code to other code.